TNTM The Show presents me, Pablo Gunner, and my guests right here from the podcast that wouldn't die.
What's up? This is Kevin.
And this is Aaron.
We're here to talk nerdy to me. We're going to talk nerdy to each other about nerdy things, of course. The Mandalorian.
Love it.
Season 3. That recently finished up. I don't know about you, but I watched the Book of Boba Fett. I enjoyed it. I liked it, but there was...
It kind of sucked, though, let's be honest.
But there was two episodes that were legitimately The Mandalorian.
Yes.
And so if you didn't watch that, you were just like, oh, why is he here? And in the show, they didn't really explain it or show a flashback or anything. They just were like, oh, he's back with me, and that's it. So how is that as an explanation for you?
Well, I mean, they do that a lot on The Mandalorian, where it's like, here's this huge quest, and then in the first episode of the next season, like, oh yeah, we're done with that. We're good. Moving right along. I haven't finished season 3 yet. Okay. I'm only halfway through.
And the thing is that in Mandalorian, he still gets beat up. Like, the Din Djarin, he still does. He falls, he still gets beat up, he still loses fights and stuff here and there. And that's kind of like part of this new season. Just them showing more of this religion and stuff like that. I mean, I'm not going to spoil anything, but I just feel like you can't outdo Luke Skywalker showing up. Which, it's like, you built two seasons to this, and Luke Skywalker showing up and just destroying these undestroyable robots and stuff. And I'm like, you can't outdo that. Like, how are you going to outdo that? You can't. Like,
now, I read somewhere that wasn't actually, like, that was all computer, like, generated. You know what I mean? Like, it wasn't even, like, motion capture. It was literally the whole body of Mark Hamill was computer generated. Did you hear something like that as well?
That sounds terrible. I'm so over that shit.
It's a thing.
I know, like, it is. I know, see, it is. In John Wick, there are parts where he's in the car, and I see his face, and it's tracking the camera. I'm like, this is all CGI bullshit. This is just CGI.
There's something to be said for, you know, old-fashioned stuff. But it's like Peter Cushing in, what was that, Rogue One, when they kept having, like, dude's been dead for 40 years.
Can we agree that if you're dead, you should be able to just rest, and Hollywood has to stop trying to make some freakish version of you to terrify us all? Started with The Sopranos, I think. That was a bunch of shit.
I think they have to get permission from their families, which, hey, you know, I mean, if their families want to profit, I guess that's on them.
Great-grandchildren of Peter Cushing are like, hey, send us a check, whatever.
Send us a check. Kevin, I might have to get you to sign something just in case you go first, and I might just need to... with my ChatGPT or something, they can whip up something.
Well, I want to say thank you for joining me. I really appreciate for joining me on this little quest to talk nerdy. What all do you do on your podcast? What do you talk about and cover and get into?
We're the podcast that wouldn't die. We typically talk about horror and sci-fi films.
Mostly horror.
Mostly, okay. It's probably 80-20, maybe, wouldn't you say? Horror to sci-fi. I mean, in all honesty.
We're more sophisticated to say we also review science fiction.
We do. Okay. Our next movie that we're going to talk about is The Last Starfighter. So we're trying to thread it in a little more, if you haven't seen that lately. And we haven't either. So we're going to check that out for the first time in 30
years. Oh, you haven't seen that? I thought that would be a pure Kevin thing.
It is a pure Kevin thing. No question. We pick these movies. Oftentimes, they're movies from our youth, as you might imagine. And we tend to goof on it because we're trying to be kind of humorous. But I think we're fairly respectful. Except for Aaron, maybe.
Yeah, not respectful. You have to earn my respect. And you're not earning it with some of these films that are coming out. Damn it.
How dare you? We have a good time.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, from your title, I surmise that maybe, like, you've been doing this longer than anybody. And I go, like, that's why it's the podcast that doesn't die. But if you cover horror, that makes more sense with your title. And two, it's like sci-fi, like, there are elements where there is, like, that sci-fi horror, like Alien and stuff, right? Like that, Survivor sci-fi stuff.
But back to our title, that was a good guess, but that's not why. We used to have a YouTube series, the B-Movie Club, where we called it B-Movie, and maybe it started with B-Movies, then it was just random movies, and no one watched it. So we quit. We decided we have faces for podcasts, so it was recommended by a nephew, so we resurrected because we will not die. We have
a new YouTube simulcast. So if you're dying to see what we look like, here you go. Enjoy. You're welcome.
Because really, it costs us nothing to just put it out there.
How dare you? This is a work of art.
Kevin's the editor.
Okay, awesome. Yeah, Kelsey Aaron nothing.
So, and then if your kids they sign off to use your likenesses, they can continue it on.
Like crusty old Peter Cushing's headroom.
That's the plan.
Yes, that is correct. That's the plan. Yes. Good lord.
Awesome. Well, so where can we, everyone out there, find you?
We're on Twitter. We're on Facebook. We've been doing these WTF videos where we take the craziest scene of whatever movie we reviewed that week, and we put that on TikTok, put that on Instagram. And like I said, we're on Apple Podcasts, we're on Spotify, and we're on YouTube. We're everywhere. There's no escaping us.
Beware.
Awesome. Okay, do you have any final words?
Live long and prosper.
Awesome. So look forward to that for them. For us, it's all TNTM The Show, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Tumblr, YouTube, Gmail, Hotmail, everything. Oh, me on TikTok, Pablo Gunner, and talk nerdy to me.